Easter on this, the second Easter that we have celebrated during this pandemic. I am Archdeacon Janet Griffith, coming to you from St. Mark's Church in Brantford, Ontario. Alleluia! Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia! 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 And now we pray the collect for this Easter day. Let us pray that we may walk the risen life of Christ in glory. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him, grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be praise and honor, glory and might, now and in all eternity. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter began to speak to the Gentiles. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 118. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. There are glad songs of victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. The Lord has punished me severely, but he did not give me over to death. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I might enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
In the dark earth, many days has lain. A reading from Mark. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, mother of James and Salome, brought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, Who will roll away the stone from the entrance to the tomb? When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Don't be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look there in the place that they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them, and they said nothing to anyone. They were afraid.
Happy Easter. Alleluia. The Lord is risen indeed. It's been a strange and perhaps a dark Lent, as we all pushed ourselves, or continued to push ourselves, out of our comfort zones. And as we were separated again throughout yet another Lent and Easter. And as we've tried to keep up with whatever the latest guidelines and laws are to keep all of those around us safe, as we tried to understand statistics, to figure out how to do our shopping, and how to do our renewal of prescriptions, as we try to determine what color zone we are in this week. But we did it. We have not had the Holy Week that we used to be used to before 2020, from 2019 and before. We haven't had some of those familiar routines, such as figuring out what our favorite Easter music is or rituals for worship. And we probably haven't gone buying all the chocolate that we normally would be doing, or the lilies, or preparing the Easter feast. But despite not having all of these things, Easter has come anyway. Easter has come anyway. Jesus has been arrested, tried, and crucified despite COVID. But even more wonderfully, he has risen from the dead anyway. He has brought light into a world of darkness anyway. Gosh, I remember saying some of those words last year.
On Friday, Christ gave his life on the cross for you and for me because he loves us. He loved us when we were in our mother's womb. He loves us with all our faults. And because of his love for us, a love that's as real today as it was more than 2,000 years ago, because of his love for us, we have hope. Jesus rose. And we are a resurrection people. We are an Easter people. Christ's resurrection is the center of our Christian faith. And many are saying that this pandemic has pushed us all to look at what is important and what's necessary. And it's startled us all out of our comfort zones. It's made a wake-up call for many. But guess what? Jesus' resurrection was God's wake-up call to the world. It startles both believers and doubters out of their ways. Death does not have the final word. There is more to come. Because of the open tomb, we know there is a place for us in God's future. And when this pandemic is over, I remember last year thinking it would be weeks, we can choose, we can try to pretend that the year from March 2020 didn't change everything in our lives. We can try to return to the same old routines if we even remember what those were. And we can, you know, use and abuse God's creation like we did. Or we can use this opportunity and all of the learnings that we've had over this year to determine what is important, and it's given us an opportunity to look at things through new eyes. What if we use that? We know that Jesus' followers in his day were startled out of their way of living. And they took courage to challenge the social norms of their day, to reach out to lepers and outcasts and Gentiles, and to spend their earthly lives for the sake of the greater life in God. They knew that when they took those risks, they were not alone. They were already living in the freedom of God's kingdom. Because of the light of Christ, because of his resurrection, because of God's love for us in sending Jesus, we have hope. We have light. We have love. And we, a resurrection people, are called to share that. I know you've been reaching out in light and love and care to all of those around you as you're able. Well, we're called to continue doing that for the balance of this pandemic, but for the balance of our lives. We are called to bring about the kingdom of God here on this earth. Brothers and sisters in Christ, Easter announces new possibilities for you and for me. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah! In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again and ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
In joy and hope, let us pray to the Father that our risen Savior may fill all of us with the joy of his glorious and life-giving resurrection. We pray saying, Lord, in your mercy, and responding with hear our prayer. We pray that isolated and persecuted churches find fresh strength in the good news of Easter. We thank you for this assembly. We pray that you may keep us free from here and keep us healthy to renew us in faith. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In you, O God, all things are possible. Grant us wisdom, integrity, knowledge, and strength to do what is needed during these difficult times. We acknowledge your great gift of all life and become co-creators with you, where we live in responsibility and love to all you have created. We pray that he may provide for those who lack food, work, or shelter, and that by his power, war and famine may cease through all the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. May he reveal the light of his presence to the sick, the weak, and the dying. May he comfort and strengthen them in their time of need. We pray especially for those on our parish prayer list, both silently or aloud. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that all who have died in the faith of the resurrection may be raised on the last day as he promised. We pray to the Father. We give thanks for the life and witness of Elwin Preston Bliss and for peace for Sharon, Kim, Bianca, and Sean. We give thanks for the life and witness of James Pilkington and grant peace to his extended family. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. As his death has recalled us to life, so his continual presence in us may raise us to eternal joy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray as our Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Praise the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
He has given us new life and hope by raising Jesus from the dead.
God has claimed us as his own.
He has brought us out of darkness. He has made us light to the world.
Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, may the peace of Christ, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you this day and evermore. Amen. Christ is risen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Christ is risen indeed.
Alleluia.
Angels robed in splendor, rolled the stone away, kept the folded grave clothes where your body lay. Yours be the glory, risen conquering Son. Endless is the victory over death you won. See, Jesus meets us, risen from the tomb. Lovingly he greets us, shatters fear and gloom. Let the church with gladness hymns of triumph sing. For her Lord is living, death has lost its sting. Yours be the glory, risen conquering Son. Endless is the victory over death you won.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah.